Hey there, Brainy here, and today I'm coming at you with a very interesting question. The question is, what's the big difference between i3, i5, and i7? For those who really don't understand, this video is for you, so stay tuned and let's get into it. So first off, I need to explain what i3, i5, and i7 are. More specifically, what does a processor do for your PC? A computer processor, which is commonly referred to as a CPU, is responsible for fetching, decoding, executing, and writing back information that it receives from the coding that is present in programs. A CPU is the main unit in a computer that allows the computer to function using programmable information and a user interface. In layman terms, a computer's processor kind of manages all the activities that go on within the system. Now let's get into the actual question at hand. What's the big difference between i3, i5, and i7? Intel Core i3, Core i5, and Core i7 CPUs have been around since 2011. Each year, Intel launches new chips based on newer technology that keeps the same names and makes things even more confusing. In general, Core i3 chips are found in cheaper or budget PCs and laptops, while the mainstream or mid-range systems tend to have i5. Core i7 CPUs are typically reserved for and found in high-end expensive laptops and PCs. Their relative levels of processing power are based on a collection of criteria involving the number of cores, clock speed in gigahertz, size of cache, as well as Intel technologies like turbo boost and hyperthreading. And I probably suggested a few things that you may not have understood: cores, clock speed, cache, turbo boost, and hyperthreading. So let me explain a bit further. All CPUs have one or more cores, with each core being a processor itself. Most commonly, an Intel Core processor will have two physical cores, dual core, and also two virtual cores, which Intel calls hyperthreading. A processor core is a processing unit which reads instructions to perform specific actions. Instructions are chained together so that when run in real time, they make up your computer experience. Literally everything you do on your computer has to be processed by your processor. So basically, the more cores that the processor has, the better it runs. And physical processor cores are usually more powerful than virtual ones. The Core i3 range is entirely dual core, and the i5 and i7 range are all quad core. A cache is a place to store something temporarily in a computing environment. In computing, active data is often cached to shorten data access times, reduce latency, and improve input or output, or I/O. Because almost all application workload is dependent upon I/O operations, caching is used to improve application performance. For example, web browsers such as Internet Explorer, Firefox, Safari, and Chrome use a browser cache to improve performance for frequently accessed web pages. Clock speed is the speed at which a microprocessor executes instructions. Every computer contains an internal clock that regulates the rate at which instructions are executed and synchronizes all the various computer components. The CPU requires a fixed number of clock ticks or clock cycles to execute each instruction. The faster the clock, the more instructions the CPU can execute every single second. Clock speeds are expressed in megahertz or gigahertz. The internal architecture of a CPU has as much to do with a computer's performance as a clock speed, so two CPUs with the same clock speed will not necessarily perform equally. Normally, the computer processor in a laptop or desktop has a standard clock speed, which partially determines how quickly it performs. While the processor might lower its clock speed at times in order to conserve power, the clock speed which is stated when you buy the computer is the fastest clock speed you'll receive unless you decide to overclock. Intel's new Core i5 and i7 processors have a feature called Turbo Boost, which has the ability to dynamically scale up the clock speed of the processor depending on the thermal headroom available. Intel Turbo Boost monitors the current usage of a Core i5 or i7 processor to determine how close the processor is to the maximum thermal design power, or TDP. The TDP is the maximum amount of power the processor is supposed to use. If the Core i5 or i7 processor sees that it is operating well within limits, Turbo Boost kicks in. Turbo Boost is a dynamic feature, so there is no set in stone speed which the Core i5 or i7 processor will reach when in Turbo Boost. Turbo Boost operates in 133 MHz increments and will scale up until it either reaches the maximum Turbo Boost allowed or the processor comes close to its maximum TDP. Hyperthreading is a technology used by some Intel processors that allows a single processor to act like two separate processors in the operating system and the programs that use it. With hyperthreading, a processor's core processor can execute two threads of instructions sent by the operating system. Having two streams of execution units to work on allows more work to be done by the processor during each clock cycle. So that's the most you would need to know about processors right now. So in terms of which is best, there is no right or wrong answer. Kind of. It all depends on what your needs are. If you are looking to do extreme gaming and use your PC for tough tasks, an i7 processor would be recommended. If you are looking to do basic stuff, then an i3 processor would be best, and an i5 processor falls somewhere in the middle. But remember that the overall performance of a PC does not only depend on your processor. Other factors such as RAM, power supply, your motherboard, and the disk space available also come into play here. So that's about it for this video. If you liked it, learned anything new, or want more, feel free to subscribe, comment below, and give this video a thumbs up. Also, I did a video detailing exactly what an OLED display is and how it compares to a QLED display, and you can check that out by clicking on screen or using the link provided in the description below. So thanks for watching, and I will be seeing you in the next video.